Time now for the ridiculous. And tonight we're adding anyone who missed out on Dyngus Day. Yeah, it's a Dyngus Day. Now, I know you probably still haven't written all your Dyngus Day notes or your thank you notes from last year. And, you know, here it is again. Dyngus Day isn't some totally fake holiday cooked up by a Seinfeld writer like Festivus. Dyngus Day is a real thing. Obscure, but real. It's a Polish-American tradition celebrating the end of Lent the day after Easter. And all over the country, or in three places that we know for sure, there were Dyngus Day parades and parties and lots of drinking and dancing and revelry. Now, you could have gotten your dingus on in Indiana or in Ohio, but if you really want the most bang for your dingus buck, you got to shuffle off to Buffalo.
Buffalo calls itself the Dyngus Day capital of the world, and it's hard to argue when you see the festivities that break out.
Buffalo, the Dyngus Day capital of the world. Also the birthplace of the chicken wing, little known fact. They've been celebrating Dyngus Day there since the 1800s, but apparently, it really took off in the 1960s.
It caught on because, for a number of reasons. Dyngus, first of all, is a funny word. It's spelled with a Y. People don't know what it means.
It's funny because it's spelled with a Y. What does it mean anyway? My new favorite reference spot, that would be DyngusDayBuffalo.com, says Dyngus can be traced back to a medieval word meaning worthy, proper, or suitable. And here's how you celebrate Dyngus Day.
The quirky little rituals include boys sprinkling girls that they fancy with water, and the girls striking back with a tap from a pussy willow branch.
I'm not going to let you do this one. Sorry. It's really so stupid. I know, it sounds like a bunch of waterlogged drunk people hitting each other with sticks, and then of course there's the drinking and dancing and music and more drinking. There's really ain't no party like a Dyngus Day party, because a Dyngus Day party is the most random excuse to drink there is. Hey, if nothing else next year, you have a new excuse to drink if you can't hold out until Cinco de Mayo. You're welcome. And to the good citizens of Buffalo wringing out their clothes and tending to their beer and kielbasa hangover and pussy willow welts today, happy belated Dyngus Day.